What's up, guys? It's December 8th. I'm here with Andy, the hype beast.
What's up?
How was training today?
Amazing.
Amazing? Yeah. What did you like the most about training today?
The push-ups.
Push-ups?
Yeah.
Do you think you're getting better or worse?
Worse.
Well, I think you're getting better. I think Andy was just sick, so... But he'll be getting better at them. What's your goal in, like, push-ups in the future?
10 whole push-ups.
Well, I think you could do 20. Because you remember you did, like, 15 one time.
I did?
Yeah, you don't remember, but you did.
I have a bad memory, guys.
Yeah, don't worry. But what hat is that, by the way?
The North Face. Dang. The North Face.
Where can we...
collab with the sneaker speaker.
Dang. Where can we purchase this?
I don't know, honestly.
You don't
know? I found it in my closet.
Yeah, so thank you, Andy, for coming out. Now I'm going to finish off training. Andy has to go to school.
Yeah.
And as always, thank you for coming out. You want to transition away?
Sure.
All right, go ahead. Godspeed. So I'm going to finish off the training with Eric. We're going to do finishing and conditioning today. So shout out to Eric for bringing this net. It's really cool. You can get it on, I'm sure, at Dick's Sporting Goods or Amazon. They have it for sure. But yeah, tune in with you guys later. What's up, guys? Hope everyone's having a great day. I haven't filmed much, but it's because I've been studying for my finals. I've been training some clients. Today I was able to train one of my good friends that I ran cross country with when I was a freshman. He was a senior. His name's Oliver. Really nice guy. He actually graduated from Mason, and he did the degree that I'm currently doing, which is kinesiology. So I had a lot of questions for him, and it was really good to catch up with him. And, you know, it was kind of like vice versa roles, because when I was in high school doing cross country, he was like pushing me through really, really hard at workouts and so on. And now I'm training him through conditioning and some hard workouts. But he got through it, and it was just really good to catch up with him. So tomorrow, the forecast said it's supposed to snow, but I'm still going to go train. We'll see how much snow. It said 1 to 3 inches, but the weather now is like very unpredictable, and really sometimes the weather doesn't really carry out as it plans to say it does. And I'm planning to go to the gym in the morning, and then I'm going to go pick up Andy from his house, and then we're going to have a group session. There's going to be a couple new people at the training, so that should be exciting, and I'm hoping to get a good workout. And we also have a group training session at 10 a.m. with Brian, Tiffany, Jesse, and maybe some others. I think Chris might come because he has basketball practice, but we'll see. And that's most of it. I've just been really busy with studying finals. I have 4 final exams starting next week, so I have to grind it out and just push through it because, you know, I got to end on a strong note. I'm transferring to George Mason this semester, so I'll be starting classes at George Mason spring semester of 2018. I'm pretty excited. I'm just ready to get school over with. And yeah, so I hope you guys have a great day, and peace. What's up, guys? So I just wanted to talk about the Christmas lights for a second. Now it's kind of random, but ever since I watched Stranger Things season 1 and 2, it kind of reminds me of just the show of how Will and his mom communicate with each other through the upside down world. And yeah, if you haven't seen Stranger Things, go check it out. It's on Netflix. It's a great show. It's based on in like the 80s, and I just, something about the show, just, it's just a really good show overall. Just go watch it. Give me your thoughts. If you have seen it, like, comment down who's your favorite character. I just want to see, like, why. And also, like, let me know why you like the show, or if you have any other show recommendations, that'd be great. My friend Andy, he told me that a really good show is called Riverdale. I haven't seen it yet, but he said it's better than Stranger Things, so I'll have to give that a look during my winter break. But yes, that was just a random thing I wanted to say. I hope everyone has a great night, and peace. What's up, guys? Just finished up training at Lifetime, and now I'm going to be heading out to go pick up Andy. It's currently 6:35, and all I did today was just some arms and upper body because my shoulders still bother me, but you know, I still have to get a good workout in and everything. But now we're off to see Andy. Whoosh. Whoosh. What's up, guys? I'm here with Andy. It's, what's today, the 8th? I think today's December 8th, I'm pretty sure.
The 9th.
The 9th? Check your phone real quick.
I know.
You know?
It's the 9th.
Well, he said...
Easy Calabasas.
Okay, so you heard him, December 9th. And so we're going to be training right now. It's still kind of dark out, as you can tell, but we're going to get warmed up. And the moment the sun starts to rise, we'll start our training. But how do you feel today, Andy?
Amazing.
So are you ready to work hard today?
Yeah.
So you heard himself. We'll be doing some cool B-roll today. Are you excited for that? Like slow motion, some cinematic scenes?
Cinematic.
Not that cinematic.
Oh, yeah, I'm ready.
But yeah, we're going to be ripping some top bins today, right? Upper Benjamins.
The Upper Benjamins.
Every day, right?
Every day.
That's good. So we'll tune in with you guys later. But
you're different than I left you. Where you're always trying to hide all that pain behind your eyes, I don't remember. I used to think that I would always let you get to me, that I would hear your voice and hit my knees, and I would feel it all again, again. But it don't hurt like it used to. No, it don't burn like the cold steel heart. When I see you at the bar with the honey on your arm, I feel nothing at all.
Jacket.
Yeah. What's up, guys? I just finished training with Eric, Andy. And Melvin. My feet are. So how was training today?
It was really good. You gotta show them the environment.
Oh my! Look at this. So you know, for all the people saying like you know, it's too cold outside. It's never too cold, right? Never too cold. So we're out here. These guys are dedicated, you know, they come out in the most, like, you know, the worst weather, and they're still out here. Look at Melvin.
I've only been here 3 days, so not me.
But how's your feet feel
freezing,
right now?
Freezing, dude. They feel like popsicles.
You?
Yeah, dude, I can't even feel them.
Dang. How about you?
Same.
Sure?
Yeah.
That's a nice hat. Where you get that?
I forgot, dude.
Supreme?
Nah.
It's not Supreme? Dang. But thank you guys for coming out. We're going to go because it's cold. It's getting really cold, so. And thank you to Eric for dropping off Andy at his house. Yeah, so.
Are you dropping me off?
Yeah.
Dude, you didn't remember? He just told you.
No, I didn't.
He did.
Yeah, I just told you.
He did?
Yeah.
He told you like a couple. Okay, but yeah, thank you, Eric. Yeah. And yeah, we'll see you guys. We'll tune in with you guys later. Hopefully it's not snowy tomorrow, but no promises. So peace.
See you guys.
Yeah. Watch this transition right here. Last sprint. Set. Go. How was that, Tiffany?
It's good. It's cold.
It's cold?
But it's good.
That's good, that's good. Go! Good stuff, Tiffany. No worries, no worries. That was a good race. Good friendly competition. How was that, Jesse?
What competition?
Race me to the bottom.
Good training in the snow today. Great stuff from Tiffany and Jesse. They did a great job. We did all leg movements, sprints, explosive work, and if you have any questions about what we did, just comment down below. So thank you guys, and tune in with the next clip.
Oh, I forgot how you did this. That's good.
Good job, Jesse. What's up, guys? I just finished training with Jesse and Tiffany here. Thank you guys for coming out. How do you guys feel? Jesse, how do you feel right now?
Feel pretty exhausted, a little bit tight, But overall, it was a really fantastic workout. You know, got a lot of work in, a lot of conditioning, athleticism. Worked on those instead of doing our normal workout routines, just to make sure that we're elastic, flexible, and all around, you know, peak performance, essentially.
Sure, thank you. Tiffany, how do you feel?
I feel good. It was a changing climate today, but
for sure.
I think it got us moving more just so we could stay warm.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's been helping a lot.
That's good.
I feel like I've been more explosive lately.
Yeah, you looked a lot faster in the sprints for sure.
Thank you.
So I know both of you, Jesse and Tiffany, are both powerlifters. And I wanted to ask them, like, do you think conditioning is important to add to routine and not to, like, avoid it completely as a powerlifter? Jesse, like, what are your thoughts?
Yeah, for sure. Absolutely. It's very essential. In fact, I think it should be a big staple in a lot of, you know, powerlifters. Because essentially here, you know, powerlifting, you get within the 1 to 3 rep max ranges of your, you know, RPEs or your 1 rep max ranges. So essentially, that's saying that you're going to work on a lot of your slow twitch muscles. If, you know, anybody really knows about that, they can do research about slow twitch and fast twitch. And if you work on more your slow twitch, you're not going to be as explosive as you would be, you know, whether it's running, swimming, or anything around life. And if you want to be explosive, speed equals power, power equals weight moving up faster. So definitely,
yeah,
that's big thing to work on.
Tiffany, like, do you think the conditioning has helped you through, like, powerlifting?
I feel like I'm able to, like, recover faster in between reps. And I don't know, I just feel like this has made me, like, well, still working on an overall, like, well-rounded athlete. I need to be able to be, like, fast and explosive even when I'm powerlifting.
That's true, for sure. Like, I feel like a lot of people, they, like, you know, avoid it even though, like, they're getting that lift, you know, having a balance. And doing, like, other things other than just lifting weights is, like, key. Because, you know, doing cardio and, like, conditioning, you need a strong heart. Whereas, like, when you're weightlifting, you're building solid muscle. Mm-hmm. But, of course, you can do the same. You can get your heart rate up while lifting, for sure. But, you know, balancing it out and switching it up can always, like, help without your program and other things that you do. Whereas it doesn't matter if you're, like, you're a football player, powerlifter, bodybuilder, etc. It's always good to add some conditioning, cardio. So, but yeah, thank you guys for coming out. I know the weather sucks. It's like this is our first snowfall of Virginia of 20s, I guess.
17.
A long, long hell ass time before we got that 16-incher a couple years back.
Yeah, so this is our first snowfall. It's pretty cold out, and these guys are pretty cold, so I'm going to go because I don't want them to get sick. But thank you guys for coming out. You guys did a great job, as always. Always killing it. And both of their Instagrams will be in the link in the below. So go give them a follow. They're both very strong powerlifters, and they both will be competing in the near future. So go show them some love and support, and hope everyone has a great day. Watch this transition.